Hi, everybody. Can I get more energy? Hi, everybody. Hi. Well, that was a hell of an introduction. We're going to discuss that one later, but this is not going to be a jail story. Nope, I'm not going to do that. But what I'm going to do is we're going to talk about Jill Scott Heron. He once wrote a poem, "The Revolution Will Be Televised." And he was right for his era. It was the 70s. And although it's almost 50 years ahead of those times, I still feel that there isn't a lot of progress made. I still feel that the revolution will not be televised. And I was born and raised in Rotterdam. Kan je dat niet horen dan? Lekker op zo'n Rotterdams. And I was born here, so I feel a type of way. I'm very, like, very proud of my city. Are you proud of your city?
Yes.
And my mother came to the city as an immigrant. She was only 11 years old. And nor did she know that the decision that she made at a young age would affect her children for the rest of their lives. My mother came to this country to adapt, to be a part of this society. But I was born here. So I feel like the norms and values that go for this country, they add for me, but I add some new values to this country. I feel like I'm the new citizen of that. And there's like this big misunderstanding between her generation and mine, because I was born here. So this is my city. These are my norms. These are my values. And at a certain point in life, I realized that we need to do this together. And the sacrifices that my mother made to offer me the chances that she never had in her life, that I'm very grateful for. So I thank my mother almost every day for the sacrifices that she made. And there's like this funny thing that we have at home. So she provided me with all the chances and opportunities in my life, and I just fucked it up. Like, really fucked it up. I was like bad in school. I was like the nuisance kid. I was always the kid talking in the back. I was always okay with a 6, even a 5.5. And then I changed. I felt like the song of Nas. Do you know the song, "I Can"? I know I can be what I wanna be. If I work hard at it, I'll be where I wanna be. Shall we just try that? Shall we just do that? Okay, repeat after me. I know I can be what I wanna be. If I work hard at it, I'll be where I wanna be. Give a round of applause for yourself. And man, I fucked up, yo. I really fucked up. I even went to jail for 2 years of my life. And when I came out, after 5 weeks, I had to tell my mother in one sentence, "Mama, I'm becoming a father and I'm dropping out of school." And I was 25 and I was still afraid of my mother. I was really afraid. I was at that point, damn, she's gonna hit me in the face, she's gonna hit me in the face. But she was very happy for me. She was like, "My boy, you're getting a son." She was absolutely sure that I was getting a son. And she told me that this kid is going to bring light in your life. And I got a son. So she was very happy with it. But before I left that day, when I told my mother that I was becoming a father, I told her, "Mama, I think I'm an artist." And that was the moment she really hit me in the face. And she really hit me in the face, and not because I was an artist. She hit me because there was some doubt in my voice. She hit me because I was hesitating. I was doubting myself. And she told me, being an artist means you either go all in or you go all out. This is not an in-between job. And if you're going to quit your school, you better make sure that you educate yourself. Be an artist with a voice. Be a person people look up to. And don't just do it for yourself. Do it for the community. Start building a community. So that's the first thing that I did. I was like this nuisance artist. Can I perform for like 5 minutes? Can I perform for like 10 minutes? 10 minutes became 20 minutes. 20 minutes became 30 minutes. And that was the moment then I realized, oh my God, spoken word is boring if you gotta listen to it for 30 minutes. Boring as hell. So I fell in love with theater. Theater is like the one thing that really saved my life. And I never realized that I could be myself on stage, that I could tell stories that were bigger than mine. I did it for the community. And at my first show, back in 2013, that was called Feni Fidi Fici, there were like 200 young kids in the audience. And they looked like me, so that was the moment that I realized this is bigger than me. So I started a company, Flow. Flow is a production house, and I only work with self-made people. People with big stories. People that have been to jail just like myself. People that been raped. People that been mistreated all their life. I work with the outcast. But I don't see them as that. I just see them as people with a story. And they're inspiring as... if I can say that? They inspire me every day to become a better man, to become a better artist, to become a better person. It's never been us against them. It's always been, I feel like, us against us. Because as long as we fight over crumbs and over lust, we simply got to draw the line right there that maybe the revolution hasn't started enough or something. And the crazy thing about these kids is they are only fighting for existence, the right to be heard, the right to be themselves, the right to add value to this country. And I'm very grateful that I can be the leader of these kids. So these kids are so inspiring. They travel all across the globe to tell their stories, to inspire thousands of other people just by being themselves. So I feel like if we can be ourselves, y'all can be yourselves. Right? Right? Yes. So what are we going to do to start a revolution? Be ourselves. And I think this revolution will be televised. Why? Because we got Facebook. We got YouTube. We got Instagram. The revolution is on a 6-inch screen. So what is stopping us from starting the revolution? And of course we had Obama. True. Of course we have a mayor that was born in Morocco. And of course, we got a few people in powerful positions, but it isn't enough. We need each and every one of y'all, like you need me, to start a revolution. So what are we going to do today to start the revolution? We need to talk about it. We need to be ourselves. We need to tell our stories. We need to be the person that our kids look up to. And I want to thank you for listening to me. My name is YMP. Let's start a revolution.